Hi. Just last week, Unity made quite an announcement. They unveiled their AI platform. It got me thinking about all the games people have crafted using ChatGPT, something I myself haven't done yet. I didn't want to be left out, so I decided it's time to create a game with only AI-generated code. Today, I'm going to employ the GPT-4-powered Bing Chat to write some Unity code. I'm not rooting to be replaced by AI, but I hope I'll be able to put together a completed game. I figured a hyper-casual game would be appropriate in terms of complexity, so here's my game idea. You ride a bike on an endless highway, and your goal is to avoid colliding with the cars. I quickly modeled these cars in Blender, and here's the player on their bike. Please don't judge me for my modeling skills. These are supposed to be used for prototyping only. Anyway, the first step was to add a quad mesh for the road and apply a texture to it. Then I added a small cube to serve as our player, at least for now. After that, I politely asked the AI to provide me with the code to move the player left and right. If you ever wanted to chat with an AI, I recommend being polite too, just in case one day we end up in a dystopian world controlled by ChatGPTs. After copy and pasting the generated code, I attached it to our player. Seems like we should reduce the speed. Well, now the player is just stuck to the road. I'm going to create a physics material to eliminate any friction the player may have. It failed to work the way I wanted, so I asked the AI to move the rigid body instead of adding force to it. Okay, that's better. Next, I asked the AI to make the player move only when holding down the mouse button. I decided to freeze the player's position on the y-axis and disable gravity, so it hovers instead of being dragged on the road. I did this because the movement wasn't very smooth. The AI suggested using move position instead of directly changing the position, which may have improved it slightly, but there's still some lagging, which I believe has to do with the input. Anyway, now that we can move left and right, let's make the road's texture scroll, giving us the illusion that we're also moving forward. I asked the AI if it's better to implement it using C# or a custom shader, and it chose C#. This time it worked fine on the first try, so I must have provided a better prompt. Later, I placed my masterpiece bike model as the child of our player. I thought tilting the bike with the movement would help make it look less unnatural. The bike is the child of the player, so I asked the AI to rotate the player's child with the mouse as well. Looking at the bike's transform, I noticed that it was rotating, but only by 1 degree at a time. So I asked the AI to give me control over the rotation amount, and it did. Now I have this rotation speed property that I can tweak in the inspector. 45 doesn't seem to be enough. Let's go with 450. Isn't it supposed to tilt the other way? Well, now it looks even more unnatural than before, so let's fix that. I asked the AI to reset the rotation smoothly, regardless of whether the mouse button is pressed or not. Strangely, it decided to put the movement code outside the mouse button conditional and only perform rotation when the mouse button is pressed. I tried to make it fix its mistake, but couldn't, so I asked it to undo its last changes. Knowing that my previous instructions confused the AI, I rephrased it as smoothly rotate it to its original rotation every frame. It once again placed the movement code outside the mouse button conditional and reset it the rotation only when the mouse button is not pressed. I don't know how it got this idea. I explicitly instructed it to perform the rotation every frame. No matter how I rephrased it, it didn't seem to understand that the movement code should also be placed within the if statement. So this time I explicitly told it where to put those lines. After more prompting, I finally got it to work. I modeled these blocks and placed them on each side of the road so that the player can't fall off. I tagged the walls as obstacles and asked the AI to make the player die when collided with objects tagged obstacle. I didn't want the player to vanish, so I requested the AI to set the game state to game over instead of destroying the object. Additionally, I wanted the crashing sound effect to play upon the player's death. I asked the AI to generate the game manager class as well, and it took it upon itself to make it a singleton and show a text when the game is over. I found myself quite satisfied with those additions. Next thing would be to stop the player from moving after they're dead, and restart the game by clicking. The AI seemed to have forgotten that the game over boolean was used in the player's script, making it private and resulting in an error. Another mistake the AI made was checking for get mouse button instead of get mouse button down, causing the game to immediately restart whenever it was over. And when I prompted the AI to fix it, it decided to add a 1 second delay before restarting. I suggested that it should use get mouse button down, and the AI seemed to like my suggestion. Next, I asked it to show the player's score and the high score. It did store the high score in the player preferences, but it never loaded it anywhere. I didn't want to outright tell it what to do, and instead told it what it was doing wrong. And things got a little weird, and it couldn't fix it, so I eventually decided to just instruct it to load the high score from the player preferences. After a little more of giving it instructions, it did work as I expected. Finally, it was time to add some cars for the player to dodge. I added a collider to each of my car models and tagged them as obstacle. Then I made them into prefabs so they can be spawned. I asked the AI to give me a car script that moves the cars with a direction and a speed. Later, I asked it to make the speed random and it made a silly mistake. I don't judge it though, I sometimes make such mistakes too. and it even apologized for making that mistake. Good boy. Now, if I place these cars on the road, we have something to dodge. But of course, we're not gonna place them, but rather spawn them. So, I need a spawner script. The spawner code should take a list of prefabs and spawn them randomly from a list of spawn points. I created 4 spawn points and assigned them to the generated script. That's not quite what I had in mind. Spawning these prefabs endlessly and moving them towards infinity is not the best practice for performance. So I asked the AI to implement the object pooling design, and to my surprise, it did it flawlessly. Well, there was this one error, but after having that fixed, it worked like a charm. You can see that it's enabling and disabling the objects in the pool, reusing the same prefab instances. That's just crazy. With the gameplay mechanics implemented, I started asset hunting in Sketchfab, imported a font and animated a few things. And here's how the polished game looks like. Okay, so now that I've coded the entire game with ChatGPT, I think I earned the audacity to have my hot take on AI and the future of programming. So, will AI replace us? Absolutely not sure. I guess time will tell. But if you want to know what I think, which you should, because why not? I think computers will never be able to do what people can. Not until they're conscious and have feelings and the ability to think, which will be never. I could be wrong though, computers might become self-aware any day now and take over the planet or fall in love or whatever. But I think the odds of that is even less than, say, a zombie outbreak. Are we worried about a zombie apocalypse now? Well, I'm not. I love zombies. I will admit though, these GPT models will most certainly improve the programming workflow, which currently is something like Googling, copy and pasting, and debugging. It will change that into chatting. You may or may not do the copy and pasting depending on where you did the chatting, and the debugging process will be again, chatting back and forth with the AI, prompting it with the error or explaining the bug, hoping it gives you a code that works. But if it doesn't, that's when your programming skills will save you. Anyway, that's my take on AI. Let me know what you think in the comment section, and until next time, have a nice rest of your day.